we can have a familiarization when contact classes starts. Now straight away we can move to the subject. So let me put the PowerPoint presentation. Can you see the PPT? Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. So the course code is ME401. Subject name is Design of Machine Elements 1. So before starting the subject, what I have to told you is this Design of Machine Elements is somewhat considered as a some sort of difficulty is there, because it consists of lot of numericals as well as for solving the problems of Design of Machine Elements you need a thorough knowledge of strength of materials. So my advice to you is along with this Design of Machine Elements you may recapitulize your the concepts you have studied in strength of materials. So because we want all those things, what are principal stresses, how bending of beam occurs, more concepts, and that idea is needed. So for first module it will not make some problem, but when we move to second module onwards, concepts of strength of material is very much essential. So my advice is along with this course you have to make a revision of your strength of material subject, so that the subject will be a simple one. Otherwise it will be a troublemaking subject. Okay, you follow? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, these are the course objectives: to review concept of statics and strength of materials. Okay, the first course objective itself is the review of strength of materials. Only if we have a thorough knowledge of strength of materials, we will be able to solve numericals in Design of Machine Elements. So that thing you have to keep in mind. The second course objective is to introduce fundamental approaches to failure prevention of components. Okay. Failure prevention is the prime objective of Design of Machine Elements. You may have studied lot of machine elements which may induces a large amount of stresses while it is operating, due to when this induction of stress approaches a high value, that machine element may fail. So we have to design a machine element in such a manner that the failure should not occur. Complete arresting of failure is not possible, but we have to increase the life of the machine component. Design should be done in that manner. You have studied shaft, right? Shaft you have studied. Hello, anyone respond please?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, when a shaft is rotating, what kind of stress it may induces? Can you remember? In a rotating shaft, which kind of stress it may induce? Yes. When it is rotating, torsion is there, then due to the torsion, torsional shear stress will develop. That is the case in a that is the case of a rotating shaft. Okay, in case of rotating shaft, there will be torsional shear stress. So due to this, when it approaches a high value, chance of failure are there. Similarly, this is only the case of shaft. Similarly, lot of machine elements are there that also failure may occur. So we have to design a machine in such a manner that it should not fail, or the life of the machine should be a huge value. Okay. Now the third objective is to provide knowledge in the design of common machine elements such as fasteners, shaft, springs, quarter joints, and coupling. All these things, design problems, we will do in the upcoming modules. Designing of threaded fasteners is included in your syllabus. Designing of shaft is also included in your syllabus. Design of springs, leaf spring and coil spring, both design is there. And designing of quarter joints is there. Designing of couplings is there. Okay, this all problem we will come when module progresses. So expected outcome. So first outcome, after studying this course, what we expect is you have to be in a position to find out various stresses induced in a machine element under different type of loading condition. Okay, loading condition may varies. Sometimes direct stresses may be there. Sometimes fluctuating stresses may be there. If you consider the example of this connecting rod, okay, it is continuously acting tension and compression. Okay, it is moving up. Okay, so such kind of loading condition may vary. So in any loading condition, we may be in a position to find out stresses induced in a machine element. That is an expected outcome. And device machine component is for its conceptual design, that after studying the course, you have to be in a position to design a machine element. So these are the textbooks usually referred for design of machine elements. If you want, you can note down Jalaluddin. Jalaluddin is the author of machine design. Anuradha Publications, Chennai, as well as R.L. Norton. R.L. Norton is a very famous author of design of machine elements. Okay, and then V.B. Bhandari, that is also an Indian author. His book, Design of Machine Elements, published under McGraw-Hill Publication. And R.S. Kurumi, a textbook of machine design. So for simple understanding of the subject, you can refer R.S. Kurumi, a textbook of machine design. This Jalaluddin also is good for examination purpose. So it is better to refer these two textbooks for design of machine elements, Kurumi and Jalaluddin. So these are the front pages of that two textbooks. These two books are available in our library. Okay. For problem solving as well as for theory, these two books are sufficient. So one important point is there. So for solving machine design problems in the examination hall, university permit you to take out design data handbooks. Okay. Design data handbook entry is permitted. So you can take this design data book to the examination hall. Two data books are available. One is K. Mahadevan, K. Balaveera Reddy, Design of Data Handbook. And another one is Design Data Book by PSG Tech. Anything you can use. It is better to use Design Data Handbook by PSG and Tech. Any one of the data book is mandatory for solving problems. Okay. Is that clear? Hello?
യെസ് സർ.
ഓക്കെ. അപ്പോൾ ഡിസൈൻ ഡാറ്റയുടെ ഏതെങ്കിലും ഒരു ഡാറ്റ ബുക്ക് സംഘടിപ്പിക്കാൻ നോക്കുക. അത് നമുക്ക് വേണം, പ്രോബ്ലം ചെയ്യാൻ ഡാറ്റ ബുക്ക് വേണം നിർബന്ധമായിട്ടും. കേട്ടോ, ഏതെങ്കിലും ഒരു ഡാറ്റ ബുക്ക്, ഇന്നത് വേണമെന്നില്ല, ഏതെങ്കിലും ഒരു ഡാറ്റ ബുക്ക്. അത് ഫസ്റ്റ് മൊഡ്യൂളിൻ്റെ സമയത്തൊന്നും ആവശ്യം വരില്ല, സെക്കൻഡ് മൊഡ്യൂൾ തൊട്ട് ഡിസൈൻ ഡാറ്റ ഹാൻഡ് ബുക്ക് ഈസ് മാൻഡേറ്ററി. ലൈബ്രറിയിൽ അവൈലബിൾ ആണ്, അവിടെ നിന്ന് എടുത്താലും മതി. ഓക്കെ. ഹലോ,
ഓക്കെ സർ.
ക്യാൻ യു എനിവൺ റെസ്പോണ്ട് പ്ലീസ്? ഓക്കെ. സോ ആസ് ഐ ഹാവ് മെൻഷൻഡ്, ഫ്രം ദ സിലബസ് ഇറ്റ്സെൽഫ് ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് വെരി ക്ലിയർലി മെൻഷൻഡ് ദാറ്റ് ബേസിക് നോളജ് ഓൺ സ്ട്രെങ്ത് ഓഫ് മെറ്റീരിയൽ ഈസ് എ പ്രീ റിക്വസിറ്റ് ഫോർ സ്റ്റഡിയിങ് ദിസ് സബ്ജക്ട്. ഓക്കെ, ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് എ പ്രീ റിക്വസിറ്റ്. ആഫ്റ്റർ സ്റ്റഡിയിങ് സ്ട്രെങ്ത് ഓഫ് മെറ്റീരിയൽ ഓൺലി എ സ്റ്റുഡൻറ്റ് ക്യാൻ അണ്ടർസ്റ്റാൻഡ് ദ കൺസെപ്റ്റ്സ് ഓഫ് മെഷീൻ ഡിസൈൻ. സോ once again I am saying, you have to recapitulate the concepts of strength of materials, especially the concept of principal stresses, that bending stress induction, that equation is there. Can you remember that equation, bending of beam? Some equation you have studied in strength of material to find out bending stress in beam. Anyone? Hello? Some section modulus, something like that. Have you heard? Section modulus. Using bending moment, find out bending stress in beam. You remember? Hello, is it audible? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you remember that equation? Okay, if not remembering, that's not a problem, that's not an issue. You just recapitulate all those concepts. That equation is m by i is equal to sigma by y is equal to e by r. So if you find out the bending moment, how bending stress is find out, that is find out using that equation, that is in case of bending, as well as principal stress concept is also needed for solving problems in theories of failure. Okay, have you heard about principal stresses? Maximum principal stress, minimum principal stress. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Maximum principal stress, minimum principal stress കേട്ടിട്ടുണ്ടോ? ആരെങ്കിലും ഒന്ന് റെസ്പോണ്ട് ചെയ്യൂ. കേട്ടിട്ടില്ലെങ്കിൽ കുഴപ്പമില്ല, നമുക്ക് പഠിക്കാം. നിങ്ങളൊന്ന് റെസ്പോണ്ട് ചെയ്താലേ നിങ്ങൾ ഇതിൻ്റെ അകത്ത് ഉണ്ടെന്ന് എനിക്ക് മനസ്സിലാവുള്ളൂ. ഓക്കെ, യു സോൾവ് ദോസ് തിങ്സ്. നൗ കമ്മിങ് ടു ദ സിലബസ്. We have introduction to design, then simple stresses and strain development, theories of failure, shock and impact loads, design of joints we will in springs, we will study design of helical springs, leaf springs, that all things, and design of shafts, then design of couplings, muff coupling, flanged coupling, lot of couplings are there. For what purpose couplings are used, can anyone respond? Use of coupling? No response. Okay, leave it. We can study it at that time. So, introduction to design. Design is essentially making. Decision making in the sense, in design, while designing, we have to choose which material should be selected, what should be its dimension. These dimensions are find out based on the strength carrying capability. So usually it is a decision making process in a design. For every problem, we need to design a solution. Okay, so design is somewhat always happening in our day-to-day life. Okay, design is to formulate a plan to satisfy a particular need and to create something with a physical reality. Okay, some physical reality we have to manipulate. So for that, what machine we have to use, all those things that comes under design. So next definition is, design is the process or systems to accomplish a specific work optimally by solving various constraints with the help of various creative ideas and principles obtained from science and technology. You note the term optimally. We have to get an optimum design for the output. There may be lot of solutions, but we have to choose the optimum one. Okay, optimum in the sense, of cost as well as in the sense of strength. Cost reduction also considered, that not considered strength design, but that also comes under design. Now consider a practical example of design of a chair. So if you have given a problem to design a chair, you have to design a chair. What will be the considerations, or what will be the things you will take into account for design of a chair? Just to respond. If you chair, what parameters or what things you will keep in mind while designing of a chair?
Comfortable.
Yes. Comfortable. Okay, it should be comfortable. Then
weight.
Yes. Weight. That's a very important. Yes. അതിന് എത്ര വെയിറ്റ് താങ്ങാൻ പറ്റും എന്നുള്ളത് നമ്മൾ കൺസിഡർ ചെയ്യണം. അതിൻ്റെ ലോഡ് കാരിയിങ് കേപ്പബിലിറ്റി എത്രയാണെന്ന് നോക്കണം. അതുപോലെ അതിലിരിക്കുന്നയാളുടെ ഇരിക്കുന്നയാൾക്ക് കംഫർട്ട് ആയിരിക്കണം നിങ്ങൾ ഡിസൈൻ ചെയ്ത ചെയർ. ദാറ്റ്സ് ഓൾസോ ഇമ്പോർട്ടൻ്റ്. ദെൻ വേറെ എന്തൊക്കെ കൺസിഡർ ചെയ്യേണ്ടി വരും? യെസ്, മെറ്റീരിയൽ കോസ്റ്റ് ഈസ് ഓൾസോ എ കൺസിഡറേഷൻ. Anything else? It's a aesthetics also a factor, no? When we look at chair, it's a aesthetics. Aesthetics, you understand? അതിന്റെ ബാഹ്യ സൗന്ദര്യവും ആളുകൾ നോക്കത്തില്ലേ? ഒരു കടയിൽ പോകുന്ന ഒരുപാട് ചെയേഴ്സ് ഉണ്ട്, അപ്പോ അതൊരു കൺസിഡറേഷൻ ആണ്. ഓക്കെ, സോ വാട്ട് ഐ മീൻ ഈസ് lot of factors will be there while designing a component. It is a simple chair, but for designing that chair itself, we have to consider a lot of factors and parameters and while designing that chair. Sometimes chair its objective may differ. Chair can be used for small children's. Chair can be used for older persons. These two things cannot be designed in same fashion, right? So that all factors we should consider while designing a chair. So you look picture of three chairs. These three chairs are distinct, right? These three chairs are distinct. ഇത് ഓരോ ചെയറും മറ്റ് കസേരകളിൽ നിന്നും വ്യതിരിക്തമാണ് അല്ലേ? ആണോ?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right. So that factors we have to keep in mind while designing a component. So I have noted some of the components while designing a chair. The purpose for which chair is to be designed. What is the purpose that component has to fulfill? Sometimes the purpose carry load of a small baby. Sometimes it may be for grown up person. For grown up person, they may have backache, all those things. So it should be in the, it should be designed in a certain manner, not in the manner that a, that the chair for a baby, right? Then whether chair is to be designed for a grown up person or child, okay? Then material for chair, material cost is consideration. The strength of the material should be in a position to withstand the weight of the person sitting in that chair. That all consideration will be there. Cost consideration is there. Okay, while sharing a cost, every firm will give you a task. You have to minimize the cost. Otherwise, there is no relevance in design. Okay. Then, aesthetics of design chair. It's aesthetics. അതിന്റെ ബാഹ്യ സൗന്ദര്യം, അത്തരം കാര്യങ്ങൾ നോക്കണം. എർഗണോമിക്സ് കൺസിഡറേഷൻ. എർഗണോമിക്സ് മീൻസ് ഇറ്റ് ഷുഡ് ബി യൂസർ ഫ്രണ്ട്ലി. ഓക്കെ, ദീസ് ഓൾ ഫാക്ടേഴ്സ്, നോട്ട് ഓൺലി ദീസ് ഫാക്ടേഴ്സ്, ലോട്ട് ഓഫ് ഫാക്ടേഴ്സ്. ഐ ഹാവ് ജസ്റ്റ് മെൻഷൻഡ് സം ഓഫ് ദ ഫാക്ടേഴ്സ്. സോ ഫോർ ഡിസൈഡിങ് എ സിമ്പിൾ തിങ് ഇറ്റ് സെൽഫ് വി ഹാവ് ടു കൺസിഡർ എ ലോട്ട് ഓഫ് പോയിന്റ്സ്. ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് ഐ ഹാവ് ടു മെൻഷൻ ഹിയർ. So now we have to move on to machine design. So before that, we can, I think it is 9:20, we can stop here and go for attendance. Okay. Anyone respond, please?
Okay, sir.
Response. Okay, okay. Only 5 minutes is remaining. Okay. So from this, we can continue on next class. I will take attendance. Just a minute.